For lesson 10, let's take a good look at sign rules for adding and subtracting integers. In other words, positive and negative numbers. What do we do when we're adding and subtracting them? First, like signs, in other words, two positives or two negatives, we add the numbers and we keep the sign. If we have example number 1, we'll show us an example just like that. I have a positive 7 plus a positive 5. 7 plus 5 is something we're used to. It is a positive 12. What did you do? You added the numbers and you kept the sign. The sign was the same. Both of those numbers were positive. Look at example number 2. I've got a negative 8, and I'm adding a negative 2. Now, there's another way this could be written. It could be written as negative 8 minus 2. Still, both have negative signs. The signs are the same, so we add the numbers, and we keep the sign, which is negative. The second set of rules is for unlike signs. What do you do if you have one positive and one negative? Well, in this case, you always subtract. Now remember, these are only the rules for adding and subtracting. We'll get to multiplication and division later. When we have opposite signs, we subtract. We would say 12 minus 7 is another way to rewrite that. And of course, you subtract the numbers. What sign do we give them? Well, the sign of the larger one when we're talking absolute value. So in other words, ignore the sign. Which number is really the furthest from 0? 12 is. It's positive, so that is a positive 5 is our answer. Look at number 4, example 4. We have a negative and a positive. We're going to subtract those two numbers. Well, 13 minus 13 is going to give us 0. And this is the one case where we do not have to put a sign down because 0 does not have a positive or negative sign on it. It's just 0. All right, let's take example number 5 and see what happens with 3 numbers. Now, I'm going to rewrite this one just because you can look at it two different ways. Negative 1 plus 5 plus a negative number could be written negative 1 plus 5 minus 8. And I'm going to look at it both ways. If I said I'm going to work at two numbers at a time, I'm going to say negative 1 plus 5. Let's just put them in parentheses so you see what I'm doing. Negative 1 plus 5, opposite signs. I'm going to subtract the numbers. I'm going to say 5 minus 1. That would give me a 4. I'm going to keep the sign of the larger one, which was the 5, so it's positive. And then I'm going to bring down the rest of that expression, the negative 8, or minus 8. 4 minus 8. Opposite signs, so I have to subtract. I keep the sign of the one that's larger, so it needs to be a negative 4 is my answer. Okay, let's take a look at number 16. We could rewrite this one, and I'll do it just so you can see it both ways. It would be 18 plus negative 9 is the same as minus 9, plus 5 plus negative 2 is the same as minus 2. Now, I'm going to take two numbers at a time. I'm going to say 18 minus 9. Remember, opposite signs, I subtract, keep the sign of the larger one, so it's positive. Then let's just write down the rest of the problem, do one step at a time. Next, I'm going to take the next two. I'm going to say 9 plus 5. Well, those are both positive. I add them together, and I keep the sign. And I bring down my minus 2. And now I have to say 14 minus 2. Well, opposite signs, right? Subtract them, keep the sign of the larger one. It's a positive 12. In example 7, we need to do some evaluating. We need to plug in for the variables x and the variables y. And remember, we need to be cautious whenever we're substituting in a negative. So y is going to be tricky because y is equal to a negative 3. Let me show you how this can affect you. For example 7, I'm going to say 3 times whatever x is, and x is equal to 2. And then I'm going to say plus because the plus is in the expression. I'm going to look at what y is. Y is a negative 3. Well, I usually use parentheses to separate two signs, positive and negatives, but otherwise I'll get confused. Now, how do I simplify this or evaluate? First, I do multiplication. I say 3 times 2 is 6. And then I say plus a negative 3 is really the same as minus 3. And 6 minus 3, opposite signs, I would subtract and keep the sign of the larger one. It's the positive 6, so it would be a positive 3. Let's take a look at example 8. Almost the same expression. Instead of plus y, I have minus y. I'll say 3 times 2 because x is 2. I'll put my minus down because it's in the expression. And then I'm going to say substitute in for y a negative 3. Pay attention. There was a negative in the problem, in the expression, and there was also a negative in the value that I had to plug in. I ended up with two negatives together. What I'm going to have to do is two negatives, turn it into positive. I can say 3 times 2 is 6, and then minus negative 3 is plus 3. Well, 6 plus 3, the answer would be 9.